Okay, I just wanted to point a couple of things about this domain registration. So the first thing here is the email address, europeanrevolution@vaultletsoft.com. How interesting. Okay, so let's explore this a little bit as well. The addresses provided are always this. So you see it repeated down here, and you see it repeated up here. The registrant is the person who's being billed. So it was registered at this address. Okay, this isn't a personal address. This is a work address, and it's very specific. So just remember that anybody who's familiar with online purchasing using a credit card will acknowledge that when you fill out a form and you submit your information, there is a cross-reference check between your address on the credit card and the address provided, and the transaction gets held if the address is any different than the one that's registered to the credit card with. So we have that, and we have the picture of the GoDaddy results for the Whois. I have a similar picture, as well as I saved the source code for the HTML page. I just hit Alt F A for save as, and then enter saved it to my desktop on my old laptop, so it's still sitting around on that hard drive. But let us have a look at Vaultlet Soft. Who are they? We see here that you can have a hard drive, USB drive, or whatever, hook it up to the computer. So you could use a thumb drive, for example, go up to my laptop and plunk the thumb drive in, download your emails for this address here, let's say, for example, europeanrevolution@vaultletsoft.com. And basically what it'll allow you to do is you can then take that information and go to another computer that's totally disconnected from the internet. It's spend your time typing out responses and dealing with communications, and then you can go to George's laptop, let's say, just any random person's computer, laptop, library computer, HRDC, any of that stuff, and you'll be able to send out your email responses. So it's a two-way email communication facilitation, and from Vaultlet Mail, the server that these people have, they will send your emails encrypted so that when you're on another network, they can't even get access to what's inside your email. So they may know that somebody came along and got some messages from this place, but they won't know what's inside of them. And if you carefully examine what the system does, is it uses 256-bit AES encryption, which is pretty heavy. It would be much more probable for a child to use something, a service, something like Hushmail, for example. Hushmail would encourage privacy as well, using 256-bit PGP encryption, which isn't as secure as the AES, which may have changed. I've noticed that AES encryption has been getting weaker and weaker and weaker. There's new articles out all the time, but that's just a sidetrack. Basically, this is what people would use if they wanted encrypted emails, and even that would be a little bit extreme. Generally, if you're running a transparent process, you'd want a regular mail service, which is what something like what you or I would use. Let's have a look a little bit more about this registration here. Now, this address here, it indicates that the credit card is corporate. It is not a personal credit card. You do not register your personal credit cards to your work address. So, therefore, that is a credit card for the United Nations representative of Ecuador, and it's a corporate card. So, what I would like to know is, what kind of daughter would go up to mom and go, "Hey, mommy, I'm just going to register a domain here." She's not going to ask what it's for. "Oh, it's for the revolution." She's not going to, like, notice some of the shadier details, like europeanrevolution@vaultsoft.com. That sounds like a revolution, like she's planning on launching a revolution with a domain. Also, as a parent, personally, I would ask what the kid's registering the domain for, because you never know what they're going to do with it. They could be pirating software, and if they get busted, you would be liable for whatever damages are incurred through the use of that domain. So it would be a legal contract between you and the domain provider. Probably not such a good idea to give your kids access. And I would imagine somebody, a one percenter, who obviously has wealth, why anybody of that caliber would not question or ask questions and get some answers regarding this registration. Okay, because I can tell you, I have like a wealthy mother-in-law, and she wouldn't even think of like allowing me to register a domain using her card without like disclosure of some sort. So that's shady. I don't know why that pop-up keeps coming, but let me get through this. We have a Whois lookup currently of the domain, which in itself is pretty shady, because look, it's now domains by proxy, and so all that contact information is wiped out. Now you're asking yourself, well, what does this prove? Somebody could have faked those pictures. Well, I couldn't fake their own press release. So a brief misunderstanding, 15october.net. It's a brief press release regarding, let me just try it again, press release okay, I'm gonna pull up the name here. So a brief press release to solve misunderstandings. So I can go back into here and go a brief press release to solve misunderstandings. Ah, here we go. So you can see the domain, it's 15october.net. It is from that website. This is a press release from October 18th, 2011. And it says, a brief press release to solve misunderstandings. I'll let you read it at your leisure and stuff while I'm talking here, but they're trying to refute things because, oh, it's a conspiracy, so therefore it didn't happen. It says, Paulina Arcos, who figures as the owner of the domain, is the name of the mother of this member. So they're admitting to it. They're admitting to it because they're saying, we used her credit card to purchase the domain in July. Oh, okay. And which credit card is that? It's the corporate card for the United Nations representative of Ecuador, because otherwise the address would be a personal address. And so we can gather from that information right there that not only was she aware that this was going to be the domain for the revolution based on the fact that the email address is in there, but she was probably behind this because what's the deal with the encrypted email communications that they have in there? I mean, we're talking military grade encryption. It's not necessary to go that far unless if you really do have something to hide. Because we can go over to, well, I'm sure I already showed you Vault Litsoft. You can go over there anytime, look at their products, and see what they're offering. So here we have all of our connections made. It is the United Nations that's pulling the strings here, and it isn't a little 17-year-old kid or 18-year-old. Well, I guess it'd have to be under 18 if they didn't have a credit card, because I mean, they would be a silver spoon-fed family, one of the 1%. So anywhere from like 12 to 17, we'll say. So you have a little kid asking for a credit card. Hey, mommy, can I have a credit card? And she just coincidentally sets up the domain that launches all this. Something stinks. Something is totally rotten in Denmark and the rest of the world. And people need to wake up to.